All right. Okay. On to the totally real first attempt with this method. This time I will not forget to feed my units. This time I will remember. First, this time we're going with range and attack. Do not want to space my units too far out. So do this one. Eat all. Now just max out Ocean. On Dark Flame Lover and her take care of the rest. The most part. See, holy bro. Like, it's a stun needs to be studied in a lab or something, bro, because there's no way it's just that strong. There's no reason to, like, come on, man. They got me like this. Speaking of that, let's just space out all the units. Try to max out as much as we possibly can. Rias will take care of everything for now. Hopefully. That's assuming she doesn't sell my bag. Let's get Yuta maxing. Maximizing his damage. I'm sure not auto skipping would be a fine idea, which is exactly what I'm about to do, because not gonna lie, I want you to actually raise his attack this time. Because having a razor attack in the final quarter is not fun at all. I see Yuta has 135. I think Gojo has more range. I'm confident placing him back here. Uta doesn't count, so the waves will keep on going. Of course they will. Now, these waves in early as hell themselves, anyways. I just won't have auto skip on them. Whatever's making me more money. Okay, what is reasonable? Alright, start off with blue. Then we'll have another Gojo right here. And then he'll be red. Ideally, he does not get stunned at all. Because I need somebody, anybody at this point, to just knock these guys back. And Gojo keeps on getting stunned, so he can't even do his blue. Wow, she really just stunned off rip like that? That is just like, how do you fight that? She's already stuck. Let's go, go. Alright, at least we applied him with it once. Is it a win in my books? I'll place the other Gojo right here. He won't be reaching majority of the time, but hopefully he reaches enough of the time. Yeah, they're still raising it. I think he's done raising attack, right? Yeah, I got it in upgrade and he's not done. I might have to time stop here, bro. Why is Aizen so tanky? Why can he just regen his HP like that? Oh, I guess everything's fine.
It's gonna be alright.
Now everything was alright, and then this happened. Hey, Yuta, hurry up and raise your attack already. If wouldn't even help. Dude, I don't got a choice. He can heal and void. Wow. If anything, he's healing faster because he's in the void. How exactly does that make sense? What could I have done differently here? Would maxing out Yuta even help? I mean, it seems to be helping Loki. Thank God I turned off auto-scape. I would have been cooked already. Not gonna lie, surprisingly enough, I'm pretty sure Shoko made it farther than this, so... Hey, say what you want about Shoko, but she's clearly putting up numbers in this kind of stage. But, hey, we'll see. It's not over yet. The whole setup with Gojo, it might be worth more time to just bring Shoko. His runs will naturally be faster. Let me just put on red. He gets stunned too much to even think about applying debuffs. Like, look at that stun, bro. So far, the stun is doing well. Definitely serving its purpose. But what I needed to do is, like, damage Yuta enough so that she keeps on healing instead of stunning us. That, if we could do that, then that'd be amazing. And Aizen's already here. I'm not sure if we can beat that tanky of an Aizen that regenerates the HP. And we probably won't even have a void. Well, this is bad. Like, really bad. How much damage does Yuta have? Less than before. No shocker. I think bringing in... That is, like, what you should be doing. All you can do is wait and hope for the void to come back. But by the time Void comes back, I think they'll be too far. Yuta's range caps out, probably around here, because I'm looking at the one all the way in the back. Rias' range, that's the one all the way in the back, so it caps out around here. I don't think we have enough time nor the DPS to actually this. Which is unfortunate, but... Hey. At least we figured out that Shoko is most likely better for this stage. Since Yuta loves stunning units. But she's not harassing my goats anymore. So maybe there's hope. Unless you plan on spreading your units out and actually like trying this like seriously, like tactically and stuff like that. Bring Gojo. But if you're not gonna do that, then I strongly advise you just bring Shoko, because she's just way more usable and just feels and functions way better. But having somebody attack Yuta, like specifically, might help in this situation. I'm not too sure. I have to see more of my own time, but for now, I think the Undisputed Champion. Let's just auto skip. We're here for the waves, not to live forever. Alright, is this gonna do anything to our current issue of Aizen not dying? Oh, you already made out of range, so it don't even matter. If Aizen wasn't killing us, these resist enemies sure were. Well, we got more metal back here. Metal at 40. Is that 100 mil metal, bro? I don't know. Ugh. I do admit, not auto skipping was definitely not the move. Gojo seems to be handling this pretty well. Let's consider. Huh. I think bringing Gojo might be better as a whole, because yeah, they're getting more damage. Yeah, bringing Gojo is definitely better as a whole. If you're just auto skipping, which you should be, like, we're only here for the waves. It's unfortunate that Aizen makes it by so quickly. Jeez, that's 11 bill. But I think that's a pretty good run. 5 chocolates. Okay, that is Shoko and Gojo, 2 teams you can use. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and see you. We'll just hope screenshot worked for me right there.